80% of the people in Palestine who have died are civilians. So if they're going to great care, they're not doing a very good job. I also don't begin from the place of, because Alan always begins from placing Israel in a defensive position and saying, what would you do if these people were firing upon you? The problem with that logic is that that begins with Palestinian resistance as opposed to Israeli occupation. If you begin from the place of Israeli occupation and you talk about Palestinian resistance to that, then suddenly the question should be, what would you do if you're Israel and you're an apartheid state and you're an occupying force? That to me is the more fundamental question here. And again, I'm not, hold on, Alan, please. And once again, I'm not defending the killing of innocent children. I'm not defending breaking of ceasefires. I'm not suggesting that Hamas is above critique. I'm not pro Hamas. I'm anti occupation. And that's a very different conversation. And that's what the United Nations is attempting to do.
Apartheid states, we're engaging in bigotry. Look, I fought against apartheid. I was part of the legal team for Nelson Mandela. I know what apartheid is. How dare you call Israel an apartheid state? Arabs and Jews work together, live together, serve in the Knesset together. The Gaza was emptied of all occupation in 2005 and 2007.
I hope I get a chance to respond.
Israel left behind all of the greenhouses. Hamas turned them into terrorist rockets. Shame on you for calling Israel an apartheid state. Well, you have become part of the problem, not part of the solution, Mark.
Well, your moral censure aside, I'd like to respond to that. First of all, if you look right now, there's first, second, and third class citizenship for Israelis versus Arab Israelis and Palestinian Israelis. Arab Israelis and Palestinians.
Please, Alan, let Mark respond.
I am.
I'll just wait for him. Are you done? Thank you, sir. If you're talking about occupation moving ending in 2005, right now, Gaza is still controlled by land, by air, by sea. Israel still has a blockade. Israel still controls the population registry. Israel still controls the electromagnetic sphere. Israel still controls movement. Israel still controls the entering and leaving for Palestinians. It still controls the construction of supplies. It still controls the water, the food that comes in. It still controls the economy. Palestinians have not had one day of self-determination. If you don't call that second-class citizenship and an apartheid state, shame on you.
Well, you talked about Israel being an apartheid state, number one. Number two, Israel...
Address those points I made, Alan.
You're interrupting me. Gaza has had self-determination. They voted, and the foolish people in Gaza voted for Hamas, and look what it's gotten them. It's gotten them horrible conditions. It's gotten them turning the possibility of having a wonderful area of Gaza turned into a terrorist base. And when you use your civilians, by the way, another myth is that Gaza is very densely populated. Look at a map sometime, and you'll see there are areas of open space that Hamas could use to fire rockets. They choose to go to the dense areas of the Gaza Strip rather than to the empty areas, precisely because they want to incur civilian casualties. I call this the dead baby strategy. They know that when they put their rockets in front of civilian areas, Israel will have to respond, children will die, and they're ready to show those children on television. The media falls for it, you fall for it, and that only encourages Hamas to do it again and again and again.
All right, Mark, last word, then I gotta go, Mark.
I'd be curious to know, although I don't want you to answer it now, Alan, I'd be curious to know if Alan has any critique of Israel. Alan is tearing down the straw man that Hamas has things to critique, that Hamas has made mistakes, that Hamas is worthy of moral censure as well. I begin from the place of saying, look, I'm not pro-Hamas. So his critiques of Hamas, some of them I agree with. But again, Alan seems to refuse to acknowledge that everything that Hamas is doing, everything that the Palestinian people are fighting for, is from a posture of resistance to occupation. The fact that he denies that occupation, the fact that he ignores the United Nations censure of the
seven that were doing this before.
They gave me the last word.
All right,
began.
I'm going to have to end this.
They gave me the last word,
sorry.
Man.
No, okay, I got to end this here.